a lot of off-field issues with this team. As a coach, how do you deal with that?
You know, Hayden at first, he was an issue. Felony charges. He was an issue, but that much talent, we can't deny that here at Dash Maroon.
Rumors are going around that you're coming out of retirement for Saturday's game. Is this true?
I guess we'll have to see.
As one of the most skilled and talented players on Dash Maroon, what would winning a third national championship mean to you?
It would mean more than any other championship I've won in the history of my career.
A lot of critics have been calling you the postman for your inability to score goals. What do you have to say to those who doubt you?
You know, I'd say, why does it matter? We're here to be a team. It's not about the individuality. It's about the team, so our team's gonna get it done on Saturday, and that's all that counts.
So do you think we are gonna win a third national championship?
Do I think we're gonna win a third national championship?
No. I know we're gonna win a third national championship.
In last week's loss, your dog, the mascot, took a hit to the head with a ball. What are your opinions on that?
Well, he's been through a lot. He's been hit by two cars. He suffered a severe concussion last week. But you know what? He'll be back next week, and so will we.
After suffering a career-ending injury, how have you been able to contribute to this team?
Well, our head coach put me on to the special teams coordinator. I really control that whole aspect of the game, and I think we're producing, so it's all working out.
After coach moved you to team recruiter, how were you able to pick up top prospects Hayden Miller and Rodrigo Rivas?
Well, I mean, for Rod, Hot Rod, I mean, he's an Olympic gold medalist. Easily the best free agent we could have picked up. And then, I mean, I was walking down the hallways one day in school and I saw Hayden, Sidu Miller, and she's just standing there fighting with his teacher, and I knew he had to fight to get us another championship.
A big loss last week. What are your thoughts on that?
All great teams are able to defy adversity, and this is five examples of it.
Scoreless through eight games, some say your drought is permanent. What do you have to say to those doubters?
I've had a lot of off-the-field issues this year, but I'm going to come back in this last game and get the W and get a goal.
Second year as starting goalie for Dash Maroon, how do you feel like you can perform under the pressure on Saturday?
All I can say is nothing's going to get past me tomorrow.
A lot of rumors going around about problems in the locker room, specifically with Ethan Lobo. What do you have to say about that?
Well, yeah, I taught him most of what he knows today, so it's like father-son relationship. He kind of fights back and argues against my teaching sometimes. But on the field, we're a great team. We'll go together. Everything's fine.
Ethan!
What does this team mean to you?
Well, you know, this team is everything to me, man. As I like to say, my landscaping work out in the yard translates to goals on the field. That's all I have to say.
A lot of talk around the league about your new hairstyle. What do you have to say to the critics who call you flamboyant?
You know, they can say what they want, but at the end of the day, the ball's in the back of the net after I shoot it. Get that camera out of my face.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom.